Okay. Good morning. Today is Tuesday, Rosh Chodesh Kislev, the first day of Kislev, the big Yom Tov, a good Yom Tov. We know today is a Yom Tov because this is the day in 1977. The Rebbe came home after he suffered a severe heart attack in An Shmini Atzeres, right during a kafas. And on this day, Rosh Chodesh Kislev, the Rebbe came home. And this is a big, big Yom Tov for us that we are able to have the Rebbe. And imagine what we got from all those teachings and guidance from the Rebbe since that day on until today. So, Rosh Chodesh Kislev is also the beginning of a month, which is the Hasidish month. It is the month that we have the Yutis Kislev, the 19th day of Kislev, which is the Chag HaGeulah. We have, of course, the Yudalit Kislev, the day of the Rebbe's, the wedding anniversary of the Rebbe. We have the Chag HaGeulah of the Mittel Rebbe, Tes Kislev and Yud Kislev, the Pertin, the Yotzeit, and the Chag HaGeulah of Yud Kislev. So it is a general, very special month. A Geula Digger month, a month that the teaching of Hasidus was given. So this is also a time to remind everyone to share this Tanya Shir and to invite more people and friends. And indeed, in 3 weeks, we're going to start again, less than 3 weeks. We're going to start the Tanya once again on the 19th day of Kislev. That is when we start the Tanya. So it would be a good opportunity to invite more friends, and they should join us in the morning shiur at 9 o'clock, or to watch on YouTube and so on. So we are in the middle of the Kuntra Sacharin. Kuntra Sacharin is the last part of the Tanya, where there is a collection of notes that the Alter Rebbe wrote for himself. And when they later printed the Tanya, the sons of the Alter Rebbe put it together in this book of Tanya. And in these notes, the Alter Rebbe clarifies certain issues, certain things that seem to be contradicting. Some of them are very deep stuff, but again, like we said yesterday, we would bring it down as much as possible to understand it. And yesterday we spoke about that there is a difference between the davening, what happens when a person studies Torah and davens. The Torah that we study needs to rise to higher places and to accomplish what it accomplishes in the higher places, to connect to the higher levels, the higher worlds. And when you pray, when you daven, and the davening goes up to the higher world, it creates new energy, new blessing, new life, something that the source of this world doesn't have. You need to reach up higher. So we spoke about the difference between when you study Torah. When you study Torah for the wrong reasons, then it really holds it down and doesn't let it go up. However, when you daven, even if you daven not for the right reasons, still it goes up. Why? Because davening, after all, when you set when you come to shul to daven, you come to shul to daven to Hashem. Or when you daven, you set yourself up at home and you daven, you pray. What do you have in mind to pray to Hashem? But when a person studies, and then even though if during the prayer comes strange thoughts, it's not that this is what you set up for. But when a person set himself up to study Torah for the wrong reason, like for example, he wants to study Torah to become famous. So the whole setting up in the beginning is for the wrong reason. Therefore, that doesn't go up. But if you don't have any reasons, if you study Torah without any intent, then it goes up higher than davening. Because in the end of the day, if you study Torah, even if you don't have the right reasons, but if it's not for the wrong reasons, that the thoughts that you have are the thoughts of the Torah. Unlike when you pray with no kavana at all, with no intent, and your mind wanders everything in other places, you may end up in Australia, and may end up in the whole in other places during davening. So therefore, if you pray without kavana, it doesn't go up. It doesn't go up. Because your thoughts are not thoughts of prayer. However, there is one advantage in prayer without kavana, without the intent. I said yesterday, there's one advantage, and that is that it's easier to elevate. It is easier to bring up. And how? That if you daven, let's say throughout the year, you have one prayer that you daven one time with kavana, with the proper intent, then this time that you daven this prayer with intent elevates all of the previous times that you daven the same prayer without kavana. That's why this is a very good news that we have, that we can elevate our prayers during the year. When you pray, one day you pray this prayer with kavana, one day you pray the other prayer with kavana, with proper intent, and that elevates all of the previous times that you prayed this prayer without kavana. And today, the Alter Rebbe, we're going to end the third essay of Kuntra Sacher. Alter Rebbe is going to clarify some things which seem to be a little contradicting, and it makes it clear. So let's look inside. Says the Alter Rebbe, Masha Kosev Pashas Pekudei Goy Rakia Tato. What it stated in the Zohar and Parshas Pekudei, it says there that prayer without the proper intent is repelled into the lowest heaven. Which means that is allowed to rise at least to that point, to the point of the lowest heaven. Uve Parshas Vayakel, however, in another part of the Zohar, Parshas Vayakel mashma de dafka ihi mila kedekayos al keima davira derekila deleila. Over there in Vayakel, in the portion of Vayakel, it says that only if the words are proper, then it goes up to rekia deleila, to the higher heaven. This is a question actually Michael asked yesterday after the class. And Alter Rebbe here clarifies it. And it says, Loi kasha midim. This is not a problem. And he explains that there is two levels of heaven. There is the lower heaven and there's the higher heaven. The lower heaven represents Malchus of Asiya. Malchus is the lowest, the kingdom, the royalty of Asiya, the lowest level of Asiya. The world of Asiya is the lowest world. And the higher heaven represents to Ze'er Anpin, the Zoh of Asiya. Zoh is the emotional part of Asiya. Malchus of Asiya is the level which is the source of the energy of everything from this world and doesn't have anything on its own. It only receives and gives what it receives from the higher places. The Zoh of Asiya, the emotional level of Asiya, emotional attributes of Asiya, there, this is higher than the source of the world. And when we're talking about the prayer with Kavana, it goes up to the higher level of the higher heaven, which is the Zoh of Asiya, because this is what you want to accomplish through prayer. If the prayer goes up only to the source of the world, you didn't accomplish anything, because the idea of prayer is to, like I say, we say Yehi Ratzon, let it be your will. The idea is to draw something from a place which we didn't have, from higher from the source of the world. So this is what it says, "Ki et ha'toyim inun rikim demedabred goy alma," the lower level of heaven is from those heaven that govern the world. Shepashas pikudei, hein de malchus asiyah. This is the level of malchus of asiyah. Udepashas vayakel and the zode asiyah. But what it says in the Zohar and Parshas Vayakel, the portion of Vayakel, that refers to the Zoh of Atziah, which is higher. As it says in Yitzchayim, Shah Shemesh Perigimel, Gabe Zoh de Atziah, Ayin Shom. And another question the Alter Rebbe asks, V'od ha-mashma l'cho'ere Parshas Pekudei, v'gam tfilo psulo oi la'adeichel rishon sh'memenu nitches lemata, v'hu bezoh de Briah. Now the Alter Rebbe says, wait a second. It says in another place in the Zohar, in Parshas Pekudei, that even an invalid tefillah, invalid prayer, a prayer with the wrong thoughts, goes up to the higher chamber, which is Zoh de Briah, and from there it's pushed downwards. So we just said that if you pray without if you pray with the wrong kavana, without the proper intent, it doesn't go up to this level. And here in Parshas Pekudei, the Zohar says clearly that even the prayer, which is the invalid prayer, goes up to the Zoh of the world of Bria. Bria is the second highest world. Says the Alter Rebbe, loy kasha midah, that's not a question at all. Why? So I'll say it first outside, and then we'll read it inside. So basically what it says is that when you're talking about going up, what does it mean when it goes up? When you're saying something goes up, you can it's just using the term, but it can mean different things. Like they say, there was an argument between adults in a synagogue, which rabbi is greater, which rabbi is bigger, this rabbi or that rabbi. And there was and some people said, oh, this rabbi is bigger rabbi. The other one says, no, the other rabbi is a bigger rabbi. And there was a child listening to the conversation, and he says, I don't understand the question. I saw them. This rabbi is much taller than the other rabbi. So by him and the child, the bigger is how tall you are. So it's all about understanding the words. The same thing here says, when you're talking about the prayer going up, what does it mean going up? So when a prayer is a proper prayer, it goes up to the higher world. And that's where it stands. It reaches to the higher worlds, and that's where it accomplishes what it needs to accomplish, and it brings down the energy from the higher world, the blessing from the higher world, and so on. But if it's a wrong prayer, we say it also goes up there. What does it mean it goes up? It goes up means it does damage. It reaches up into the higher places, and it does damage in the higher places, and from there it's pushed down. Because the idea, when a person does something wrong, it has an effect, not only in this world, it has an effect in the higher world. So that's where he says that when the Zohar says that the wrong prayer reaches up to the highest world, it's not that it reaches up there and it stays there. It reaches up the meaning that it has an effect in the higher world, that it causes damage in the higher world. So let's continue inside. It says, "Lo ikasha midah." That's not a question. Sherei afilu kol avenis mamash kalas v'chamuru yisoyles l'sham. Because even the sins, literal sins, go up to this place. Afilu adeichel adalad, and even to the fourth chamber. But then for sure, that certain that the meaning, the quality of a scent thing, it's not identical. You cannot compare. They're only using the same name. They have a common name, but it doesn't mean that it's the same thing. But Dailam Avin. And this is suffice for the discerning, for people to understand. And here with this, he explains other things that also says in the Zohar, which gives explanation. And that also will explain what it says in the Zohar, page 247. That in the second chamber, so here there's two versions, what it says here, the one version is that there is the Memuna, the appointed one, is found, or the Levushim are there, the garments are there. In any case, what is it saying here? It says in the Zohar there that in the second chamber, Memuna ala Levushim, there is one appointed on the garments, Shemalbishim and Neshoma Mimase Amitzis. They garb the clothes, the soul, as a result from the performance of the mitzvahs. I mean, where is this place that where the clothes, the neshama with clothes that comes from, as a result from the mitzvahs? In the Heichal HaBeis, in the higher chamber, the second chamber. Even though this is in the lower level of the Gan Eden of Asiya. That is where the action of the mitzvahs reach. So that's what he explains, that the same explanation can be given there, that when we're talking about where it reaches, it depends what level it reaches. It depends how you, just like when we're talking about elevating, there's two types of elevation. The same thing is also when talking about the garments of the mitzvahs, depends which level of elevation it goes. And now the Alter Rebbe concludes, he says, Tfila psula adifa metira shalom lishma mamash. He says, an invalid prayer is better, it is superior than studying Torah with improper intention. Shehi tachas ha-shemesh. When you study Torah with the improper intention, like we said before, when you study Torah for example to become famous, then the Torah is below the sun, under the sun, it doesn't go up. But the tefillah, even if it's with the improper intention, the invalid prayer goes up into the heaven. Avo. So this, and this we explained before why. Because when you pray, even if you have the improper intention, but you came to pray, then improper intention come in, and that's why it goes up somewhere. But when you have the Torah study for the improper intention, then the whole entering, the studying the Torah is for the wrong reasons. So that's why the only way to come out from there is through teshuva, through repentance. However, aval Torah stam, but if a person studies Torah not with the improper intent, not because he wants to become famous, and it doesn't study Torah for the sake of Hashem either, just studies Torah, he's used to study Torah, he comes to us shiur. It's not for the wrong reason. He just studies Torah, he's a Jew, and he sits down and studies Torah. It's the natural love of Hashem, and he studied Torah because of this. It's the Alter Rebbe. Leigaro mehevel pien shel tinoikes shebez rabon. This is not worse than the breath of the mouth of the school children. The Gemara says that the hevel, the world stands on the breath of the mouth of the school children when they study Torah. And why is so special the study of the of children? It's called Hevel She'ein Bayim Chait. The Solik Le'ela that goes up, Mishu Hevel She'ein Bayim Chait, because it ascends aloft, goes up high, because it is breath that has no sin. Little children, they have no sin, they study simply. They don't have the proper intention, even though they study for the wrong reasons. What does it mean for the wrong reasons? Some children, they would study because they're afraid. They're going to be punished if they don't go to school. If they don't study, they're going to be punished. Or they're going to be rewarded if they do study. Nevertheless, the breath that the study of the Torah of these children goes up. Even when the children study without the proper intention, they're only afraid of the whip in the hand of the scribe, of the teacher. And look there in the Zayat at page 255. The angels, they bring up the Hevel Tinoikos Shebezraban until the Atzilus, until the highest level. And the Rebbe Rashab once said that we're talking about the Hevel Tinoikos Shebezraban, the Hevel She'en Bem Chait, that we're talking about the breath without sin, the simple learning. It could be even an adult, and an adult studies Torah, and with a natural love to Hashem. So that moment it's a Hevel. That Hevel, that breath has no sin. It's not just the person has no sin. That Hevel has no sin, and therefore it goes up. So that's why the Torah is important to study Torah, even if it's shaloi lishma, even if it's not for the right reasons, because this ultimately goes up and elevates to the higher world. This is the end of this chapter, the end of today's shiur. And Bezrat Hashem, tonight we're going to have a special Torah study shiur followed by a Fabrengen in honor of Rosh Chodesh Kislev. And everyone is invited. Join us tonight, 8:00, right here, the same station. So all the best. If you go in the bottom on YouTube, the description, you can find the link to the Zoom address. So thank you for joining. And any questions?